that point is when he assaulted me and ultimately illegally detained me for over an hour.
Is it?
That's what happened.
Okay. All right, so information that you were trying to get from the officer, did you get that information from him?
I don't think I've expressed I got it in the layout that you just asked me, sir. All
right, so you didn't get the information that you wanted from him?
My statement is what it is, sir.
All right. In reference to this accident thing, did you notice that?
Yes,
and keep in mind that just gathering information from
yes,
the case.
Yes,
so you did notice, or did you notice that it was an accident scene?
Absolutely.
Okay. And in that accident scene, did the officer at any time, did he ask you to leave the accident scene?
After you told me to stay there for a minute, yes.
Okay, so
conflicted.
So initially, he told you, hold on just a minute.
Yes.
By putting his finger up and you
after said, rolling the window up in my face.
Okay, so he said he held his index finger up.
After the window? I mean, you got a lot of explaining.
Okay, so he let the window up.
Absolutely.
And then
yes,
he said, hold on just one minute.
Yes, sir.
But he was telling you, hold on just a minute. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So that's one thing that he told you. And after that, did he tell you to do something else?
I just gave you the statement, sir.
I just told you, I'm just...
He gave me conflicting orders. When he exited the vehicle, based upon me saying what I said across the street, he then said, I need you to get back in your vehicle.
Okay, so he did tell you to hold on just 1 minute, and then he came back and told you, did he ask you at that point, did he ask you to leave the scene?
Sir, I'm not going to keep going in these circles. I just stated what I said. I mean, soon as I yelled across the street, saying, I'm sure this brother, it'd be helpful if you're doing traffic, he exited the vehicle very aggressively and told me, before I said, hold on, sir, let's not forget he stepped out in violation of COVID-19 policy here, stepped up. I said, hey, hold on. He stepped back and said, hold on, social distancing, put his mask on. He then said, I need you to get in your vehicle and leave.
Okay, so he asked you to leave the scene.
He wasn't technically on the scene at that point. He was.
Who wasn't technically on the scene?
Mr. Coleman was no longer on the scene. He was away from the scene of the accident. If you watch the video, the scene of the accident is a good, let's say about 40 feet away from where they are. So he was actually on the
other side of the street.
Yeah, there's no sidewalk, so you can't say it's a sidewalk. But if there had been a sidewalk, that's where he would have been. He would have been not in the roadway, but I guess you could say the shoulder of the road away from the scene of the accident. So he's asking him to remove himself from a scene when he's not on a scene.
Let's make sure we're clear, because there are vehicles going in and out. This is not some secured area, which is what you're trying to lock me down to.
Okay, no,
there are people walking us up.
I'm just, like I told you, I'm just gathering the information from you. And the only question I was just asking was, did he ask you to do something else? And your answer to that question is?
Well, Lieutenant Jackson, in all fairness, we have on masks. This is like your third or fourth time showing a form of frustration with me, sir. So, I mean, let's just be honest what we're doing here. If we can move on.
All right, let's not jump to accusations. Let's just stick with the facts.
Well, I mean, sir, you have to see him sign. You have to see, come on, let's be honest here, gentlemen. I mean, I know this is a legal matter.
Next question.
Thank you.
Okay. So, to your knowledge, were you within the investigative scene?
Absolutely not.
So you were not?
Absolutely not.
Okay, at any point were you told that you was under arrest?
No, I was not.
Okay. At no point were you told you was under
arrest? No, I was not.